This is Moseley Bog, and this is the wonderful Dell of Flowers, where Tolkien used to come and play with his brother Hilary. It's a drained mill pool, and it's still a magical place full of wonderful trees and atmosphere, and it must have influenced him in his writing of his books.
One of the most important points about Moseley Bog is his actual natural habitat to the wildlife, to the conservation of the wildlife in the inner city part of Birmingham. For many, many years now, Moseley Bog has been a bit of a hidden secret. Voluntary groups have helped manage it, look after it, and it's still so unspoiled. And a day like today, the sun shining, coming through the trees, it's a lovely atmosphere, whether you're with a group of people or on your own.
It's great to have a place like this in the centre of Birmingham. This is wonderful. So it's very important. The Moseley Bog is a very important place, I think.
You've got the sun pushing its way between the trees, and it's grand to come out and think, yes, we can go out and enjoy looking at the trees, the pond, and walking around.
Well, they probably played games of hide and seek, tracking through the woods, exploring, making dens, all the sort of things that boys do. He liked trees a lot, and he had favourite trees, and he used to talk to trees, which is not a bad thing anyway. His big fear was suburbanisation. He used to have nightmares about waves of houses rolling across the countryside and destroying it. He becomes one of the earliest environmentalists because he was very interested in trees, in wild places, and not a mechanised world.
When he wrote the first Tolkien book, he just looked at this blank sheet of paper and just started writing. He didn't really know what he was going to write about. It was obviously all there stored up in his mind.
Here, it's quite a mysterious place to walk through. As we see with the lights through the trees, it's quite something. I wouldn't want to walk at night time. I think I'd be a bit scared, because it is... I might see a little chappy might come creeping around the trees, so I'm not too happy about that.
It's a privilege actually to be allowed to do little bits of the plays in the wood here, and you've only got to walk around a little bit to find that your imagination is stirred in the way it must have stirred Tolkien when he was a child. And if you're here on a windy day when the wind is roaring through the trees, then you hear dragons.
I was quite surprised what is sort of is related to the Tolkien stories. I must admit I'm more of a Star Wars fan, but there again, I'll go along with it, each to his own.
It's no surprise that the story's centred around Sarehole Mill and here, because this is just such a magical place. It has a lot of atmosphere and it gets to you after a while.
And hopefully walking will get to you and become a regular part of your daily life. As well as getting you out into the fresh air and making you feel a lot fitter, walking does have some very positive health benefits too. It can help reduce the risk of heart disease.